I think the collection is this extraordinary combination between people's passions, their intellectual curiosity, and the made world. So that if you look at these collections as things that are brought in, studied, displayed, understood, and that are still have continuing relevance to the people who originally made them. There's a difficulty with highlight objects because there's such diverse collections, and every time you look at the collection, you kind of fall in love with a different part of it. I'm a North American specialist, so I have a great affection for the North American collection. There's a piece in this gallery which is a small breast ornament made from caribou incisors that came in the 1920s, and that has a sort of elegance and a simplicity of form, but it also speaks to hunting as a pursuit by men in the Arctic. It came from Southampton Island in the Hudson Bay, and it's just a really extraordinary single thing. The collection encompasses everything from the non-European and ancient world. We have an important Egyptian collection which includes some of our earliest pieces, which are 40,000 year old hand axes, all the way through the various dynasties that were part of the ancient Egyptian world, all up to the Roman period. It includes material from Korea, Japan, China, good archaeological collections from Japan, very substantial print collections from Japan, and then we have a collection of material from Africa, Oceania, the Americas, which were collected from the 18th century onwards. So the history of this collection starts at one level with the Industrial Museum of Edinburgh, which was created in the 1850s, but it also precedes that moment of founding because we encompass collections that come from the Royal Society of Edinburgh, the Society of Antiquaries of Scotland, and the University of Edinburgh. But a very important person was our founder, who was George Wilson, who elicited a lot of donations in the late 1850s from all over the world, and particularly his brother in Canada. And that's how we've got some of our very strong Native American and First Nation collections from Canada.